Now, Vatican City is abuzz with anticipation on the eve of the papal conclave. Australia's George Pell has performed his last official duty before the secret ballot begins, holding a mass and praying he and his fellow cardinals make the right choice.
For a second Sunday, Rome has no pope. But it's overrun with cardinals. George Pell has a prayer, but no hope of becoming pontiff.
Every cardinal is an official in some sense of the Church of Rome, so every cardinal has his own church. I've been coming here for 10 years, I come regularly.
His is quaint, on the capital's outskirts.
I'd much prefer to have a good community of believers than a beautiful church that was empty.
The most grand and most full were the churches of those cardinals
con purezza di cuore,
deemed favourites.
Il padre misericordioso lascia liberi.
Brazilian Cardinal Odilo Pedro Scherer has the biggest buzz.
Sì, perciò,
These services, he says, are to better prepare for the conclave, to pray with the people. I say to you all, pray with us, come with us.
To pray that we don't get it grossly wrong, that we recognise the spirit and choose wisely.
And quickly, Easter looms. On Christianity's holiest day, 1.2 billion Roman Catholics want a leader.
All expectations are that the conclave, which will start on Tuesday evening, will last just a few days, and which case next Sunday there will be somebody at the window. If there's no one at the window next Sunday, that means that the cardinals are really, really very divided and have not even come close to choosing someone to succeed Benedict. Yes, Benedict.